What's up, guys? As this year starts to slowly draw to a close, and I'm busy working on the other big videos that I'm going to be dropping hopefully before the end of the year, I am once again thinking about the future of the Saw franchise and what we're going to be seeing in 2020. Right now, all we really know is that Chris Rock came on board with Twisted Pictures and Lionsgate and pitched an idea for a ninth film in the franchise that everybody in charge felt like was the right direction. Even though it was going to upend everything that was set up in the eighth film, while also being, at least as far as we know right now, firmly planted within the timeline set up between the first eight films. Now, because I am a diehard fan of this entire series, and I've covered it from head to toe at this point, you can take my words with a huge grain of salt when I say that no matter what they do, I am going to be a fan of it. And with that, all I'm really trying to say is that when it comes to fandom and the stuff that I grew up on, I want the things that I'm familiar with and the things that I've loved for decades on end. But quite frankly, when it comes to the future of a series that I absolutely love, the one thing that I always have to ask myself, and I feel like a lot of people have to ask the same, is this really what we need from the franchise? Is it at all acceptable for a film franchise to upend everything that it's done, not only through the first part of its series, but even in its most recent sequel, in order to bring a wholly original story set within the same universe or maybe something completely different? This is something that we've seen time and time again over the last decade that has just simply irritated fans. I mean, for God's sakes, within the last 10 years, we've seen two false starts on the Terminator franchise, while one quick reboot of the Spider-Man franchise came and went without even a whimper or even a whole lot of fanfare. And as a fan of the Saw franchise, I just have this lingering feeling that this is what we're going to be dealing with when it comes to the release of the ninth entry in the series. Is Saw 9, the Organ Donor Jigsaw 2, Saw Legacy, or whatever they end up calling it, going to feel like just upending everything that came before in order to do something new, while also trying to give just a little bit to the fan base in order to make them not feel like they're just being dicked around? And honestly, from where we are right now, I couldn't tell you one way or the other. And that isn't even to say that I'm not excited for the new film. In fact, I have to tell you, I love the idea that we're getting mainstream stars with Chris Rock and Samuel Jackson taking center stage within the new film. But from what I know from background drama and just behind the scenes tidbits, is that before Chris Rock came on board for what will eventually be Saw 9, the original idea was supposed to be a heavily flashback storyline that dealt with Tobin Bell's Jigsaw character, as well as potentially a lot of other nostalgic-like sequel elements like past characters, locations, and events. I'm not entirely sure if what I've heard is 100% accurate, but when it comes to the landscape of long-running series in this current entertainment environment, the idea of a nostalgia sequel seems far more appealing, at least for me as a longtime fan, than something completely different right now. It might be a little bit much to say in a gigantic comparison that doesn't really equal out, but when you look at a long-running series that tries to do something completely different than what it's ever done before, after this many sequels, you might end up with something a little bit more akin to The Last Jedi, when you really could have gone The Force Awakens direction, at least for the first outing. But as I sit here and talk with you guys about this, I have to admit that it isn't all bad. In fact, with some of the conversations and social media postings of Josh Stolberg, one of the writers of Jigsaw, as well as this next film, he seems to be indicating that the story that they were building for Jigsaw 2 isn't over and done with, and in fact, we're going to be seeing it potentially sometime in the near future. And given some of the leaks that have been coming out when it comes to the Saw franchise, it seems like that story might be continuing sometime in the near future, maybe on the smaller screen, as there seems to be leaks and conversations about the Saw franchise getting some kind of a television adaptation. One of the things that I have argued consistently about the Saw franchise in the past is that this franchise deserves far more than periodic sequels in a franchise that nobody really cares about anymore. In fact, with its overemphasis on story, we need to go back and explore all of these characters and start interconnecting things. And the idea that Chris Rock's film might be something completely different to the story, but somehow connected to the broader universe from the first 8 films is very exciting, especially if they could potentially use the television series to shore up all of the different storylines that they were going to use for Jigsaw 2 and 3, and even lead up a little bit into the 10th film of the franchise, where everything really starts connecting, and this can be conceived or illustrated as a far more complex universe than anyone ever gave it credit before, even me or anybody else that I've talked to on this channel. So I feel like this is just a really interesting topic to talk about, especially when it comes to the Saw franchise and all the hints and speculations about its future, not only on the big screen, but the small screen as well, and anything else that they want to do with the broader universe of these characters, these locations, and everything else they can bring to the table. And for me as a fan, at least as long as all of these possibilities are still in the air, then I'm not going to be overly worried about the next film in the franchise upending everything that we knew from the first 8 films and the promise of Jigsaw itself in order to continue the story going forward. So before the new movie comes out, and as much as we can talk about whether it was good or bad or whether or not it upends the entire legacy of the franchise, or it elevates it into something new and completely different that's socially relevant and something that can continue for multiple years to come, I feel like it's personally safe to talk about the franchise being something that we want to continue, and we need to give the creative forces behind it the benefit of the doubt in order just to wait and see what they're bringing to the table. And as a fan of the franchise, that is where I'm going to be laying all of my cards right now, and I want to hear everyone in the comments section talk about as well. Are you scared of what they're going to be doing in the upcoming film, or are you excited for it to be completely new and original? Do you like the idea of them continuing the story of Jigsaw in a television format, or do you feel like they just need to skip it altogether, act like it didn't happen, and move on from 7 onward, or maybe even 6, or wherever they might pick it up? Because right now, as much as we know about this franchise and where the next film is going, anything is possible, and something about that is a little bit interesting to me. Hope everyone has enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell over by the subscriber button to notify you every single time I upload. Also, go down to the description section below, hit that link, and go follow me on Twitter, where we can talk about the Saw franchise, we can talk about any horror-related movie franchise or anything on that platform. Or, as I keep saying to everyone on these videos, if you want to do a YouTube account, if you want to talk about the same stuff that I talk about, or maybe something completely different, and you want advice, and you just, for whatever reason, watch my videos or anything, and you just think that maybe I have something to tell you, because honestly, I'm not the biggest person on this platform, obviously, but I have a whole lot of fun with it, and I do it on my own time, and it's not my job, it's just a hobby, and everything that kind of goes with this, I'm willing to talk to you guys and girls about that. I want to do that as much as possible. I've talked to a couple people about that recently, and I hopefully, you know, have given them the courage to start something that they've been wanting to do for a very long time. So that's really something that's very much always on my mind, and I want to help anyone who wants to get into doing this as well. I hope everyone is having a fantastic day. It's been real.